అంతర్యస్స బహిర్విదూతతిమిరం జ్యోతిర్మయం శాశ్వతం స్థానం ప్రాప్య విరాజతే విరమతాం అజ్ఞానమున్మూలయన్ పశ్యన్ విశ్వమపీతముల్య సత్యో పశ్యస్య పారేపర తస్మై శ్రీ రమణాయ లోకగురవే శోకస్య హంత్రే నమః. మై సల్యూటేషన్స్ టు ఆల్ ది ఎన్లైటన్డ్ ఆడియన్స్ సిట్టింగ్ హియర్, నమ సభాభ్య సభాపతిభ్యశ్చ. వి ఆర్ నౌ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ ఫర్ నెక్స్ట్ హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ ది కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ఏన్షియంట్ ఇండియన్ సేజెస్ అండ్ స్కాలర్స్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద ఫీల్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ సాసర్డోటల్ పెర్ఫార్మెన్సెస్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద ఫీల్డ్ ఆఫ్ ఎసోటరిక్ ఫిలాసఫీ, బట్ ఆన్ మోర్ ఎర్త్లీ ఏరియాస్ లైక్ గవర్నెన్స్, అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్, నార్మల్ లైఫ్. హౌ డూ వీ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ ఇట్ టుడే టు bring efficiency and sharpness to the governance today? That's what we are trying to do today. As Dr. Nareri Acharya said, the Vedas contain directives which are eternal. We talk about World Wide Web today, www. The same sentence is used by రిషి గౌతమో రహుగణా. దిస్ ఈస్ విశ్వం భవత్యేక నీడం. ది ఎంటైర్ వరల్డ్ ఈస్ నెస్టెడ్ టుగెదర్ లైక్ ఎ వెబ్. ది సేమ్ వర్డ్ వెబ్ ఈస్ యూస్డ్. అండ్ దెన్ వి టాక్ అబౌట్ సిఎస్ఆర్ అండ్ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ వెల్ఫేర్ స్టేట్ అండ్ ది కనాద హింసెల్ఫ్ హస్ సెడ్ ది పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ టూ ఫోల్డ్, నిశ్రేయ అండ్ అభ్యుదయ. Abhyudaya is the welfare of the society as a whole. Nisreya is the evolution of the individual to cosmic consciousness. Both are given a proper place in our ancient text. And we talk about Weltanschauung, a German word which means a holistic outlook on existence or life. Each Weltanschauung of each country has got threefold: the relationship of the individual to himself, the relationship of the individual to the cosmos or cosmic consciousness, or the relationship of the individual to the society. On the ancient India, whose DNA is present, cultural and philosophical DNA is inherent in all of us, the Weltanschauung says the relationship of the individual to himself is based on very great cosmic identity principle, aham brahmasmi, prajnanam brahma, tattvamasi. I am that, not even he or she, I am that. In fact, the Brahma Sutra starts with this sentence, athato brahma jignasa, which states, therefore the enquiry into the Brahman starts. You can't say really, how can you start a work with a sentence therefore? Therefore means everything which is contained, going to be contained there later, it all is already inherent in man. So the first Weltanschauung, relationship of the individual to himself, is based on aham brahmasmi. Second one, relationship of the individual is also equally, relationship of the individual to the cosmos is equally strong. It is because it's based on a great sense of wonder, as present in Nasadiya Sukta and then Vak Sukta. All these things present a great sense of wonder which makes the mind expand boundaryless. Third one, relationship of the individual to the society is based on the concept of work based on ethics, ethical existence. The governance which we are going to see in coming slides is based on the three concepts of dharma, satya and ritam. That is the foundation stone. And the work the individual does is guided by a sense of nishkamya karma, a sense of dedication without ego. In fact, if you see the entire Gita, the whole thing can be said in one sentence, only one word: don't worry. Because he starts the text saying that don't worry, asocham anvachavasastvam prajnavadam sabhashase, do not worry. And he also ends the entire 700 verse saying that Masuchaha, do not worry. So the thread, do not worry, the relaxed atmosphere to work is the essence of the Gita. So this is what the ancient text taught us. So the Vedic culture is comprehensive. It is not merely a sacerdotal text. It concerns areas like sociology, anthropology, history, psychology, etc. Then, what about the administrative system? We are now going to concentrate on administrative system. What is that? Administrative system of the ancient times, Vedic times, we can say societal, is based on how remote the value. The administrative, a participative decision making process. It is not totally participate, and we are discussing about caste system, Varna or Jati in the morning session. The caste is not a heinous division, it is an expanded family system. That's what you call the caste, because the entire work ethics, the work methodology of ancient times was based on what you call the Sreni, the guild system. The Sreni, the guild of the farmers, the guild of the blacksmiths, the guild of barbers, the guild of different types of work. So they formed their own guilds, and all even the prices of the commodities sold, and the punishments, penalties, everything was imposed and given by the leader of the Sreni. The king has nothing to do with that. He was only titular head. Everything was decided by the Sreni itself, the guild itself. Such a perfect system was in existence that during that time. Unfortunately, a decadence has set in. The majestic dream of the ancient forefathers has collapsed under human frailty. Then the king was expected to run the administration on the principles of dharma, satya and rita. That is, we have already seen that. And the king was a servant of dharma. Then, for instance, in the famous Girnar inscription, the inscription says, the king was given punishment by the elders of the society because he spent government money in repairing a tank without the permission of the council. So the council came together and penalized the king and said that he should, from his personal money, he should reimburse the state of the money which he has spent. That is not even a selfish act. He wanted to repair a tank, but then he said he has not properly done, far removed from present day society. Then there was great emphasis on result-based activities. Everything was based on what you call the critical path method. The time was fixed for every activity, every step of the activity, and any slippage, unlike what you call the time overrun, cost overrun, which you see in present governance, it was not allowed. Slippages of charges was not forgiven. Yes, it is mentioned in Samaveda itself. Then the great emphasis on courage and valor, sacrifice himself for the protection of the realm. In the Atharvana Veda, the Ajurveda says the administration should ensure abundant prosperity, intellectual eminence and versatile skills, as in the Ajurveda. It is wrongly stated in the Western history books that India's decline came. We can see later in the next session, when Kalyan, I do Kalyan Raman's paper, in the Angus Madison, he has made a research on the GDPs of the several countries. He finds that till the 12th century, the GDP of India was 34% of the GDP of the entire known world at that time, a huge percentage. and China was 24%. The rest of the world contributed to less than 50%. By the 18th century itself, not very late, India was still commanding 24%. China was also somewhere around 25%. But then, with the ascent of the Europeans, the dream collapsed. Now we are holding it about 2% of the GDP of the world. Why it happened? What happened? As Dr. Abdul Kalam says, the foreigners not only robbed us of our own prosperity and riches, they also robbed our mind of the values. So our value system collapsed and we lost confidence. As Arjuna Vishadam happened to India, Dr. David Frawley had written Awake India, Awake Bharat, Awake Arjuna. So India has collapsed because we lost our souls. It is time to refurbish that. The essential aspects. Here is the core. The Vedic administration was not aggressively combative. There was a camaraderie and very strong. You were the 10th mandala. We collapsed not because of that. We are given up. In fact, ancient Vedic text says very should learn and speak properly. Very verse of Isa was open to say. Own universe is embedded with the yearn the spend it wisely are distributing to the both the concept was there. The Mahabharata says to the Pandava so the ideas of wealth making was present there. The Vedic verses on power and empathy are the two sides of a leader, Arya Purusha, who just becomes equally fearless of the known or the unknown. Atharvana Veda says this. Then there is human dynamics. The 10th mandala of the Rig Veda talks about the importance of the participative decision making. In fact, the Purusha Suktam says by the Adi Purusha. The entire Purusha Suktam talks about a cooperative endeavor for production. Then, importance of the assembly, venue and thought to be in unison with the subject under discussion, Rig Veda. So, the entire prospect, the methodology how to conduct a meeting, we all can, when we are having this conference, I think our leaders must have learned from them. The Vedas, that's why we are doing it so perfectly, because this World Association of Vedic Studies, our inspiration comes from the Vedas. The Vedas. Take this one. The battery is gone. 5 more, okay. So, Kalidasa says, Uddabe Nasti Sagaram, you won't be able to cross a ocean on a catamaran. The Vedic society is an ocean. We are trying to cross it with a catamaran of 30 minutes. Anyway, we will. The emphasis on productivity is given in Atharvana Veda, 12th chapter. The Taittiriya Upanishad talks about the spiritual journey of Bhrigu through different levels, Annamaya Kosa, Pranamaya Kosa, Vijnanamaya Kosa, like. It's an evolution of the individual through various needs as hierarchy of needs, which much later came from the writing of Abraham Maslow. This was found in itself by the Bhrigu's journey. Then governance in the epics. How do you do? Ramayana in the Ayodhya Gandam, in the forest, Nandigram, Rama gives an advice to Bharata, how to run the administration in nearly 82 verses, completely comprehensively covering all aspects. Then he says himself is an ideal person. Maryada Purusha Rama. Gunavan Kastaveryan, Dharmajnasya Kridajnasya. So many qualities are present in him. He was the model leader. He says the king or leader who takes his due share from the people but fails to protect them as his own headman, children, commits a great praises of Rama to Arjuna, to Bharata. So are there the well-balanced leader and planning, importance of planning, balance. Then even the demons knows the concept of cross-pollination of ideas. He himself asked for suggestions from his counselors how to debate Rama. Even Surpanaka advises him. Daily exchange of ideas. Then it's a model book. It has been quoted several times. The model leader should behave as he should be the certain example which people will implicitly follow. What Jeffrey quoted in the morning. Instinctively, people follow him, becomes the leader. Then Krishna gives a practical advice. And then he says, the leader should withdraw from sensuous pleasures when tempted and keep his mind poised on the goal. This is a problem with most of the leaders, is that they might allow their mind to be diverted on smaller things. Gita says, hold on. Then Gita's advice on stress management, which I have already mentioned. First, the don't give in to worry or fear. Then he talks about the destructive effects of negative work ethics. Negative, don't be negative, always be positive. Gita also discusses the negative aspects like false pretenses of beauty, defeatism, etc., etc. Then Arthashastra, this is one of the most beautiful books in the world. Completely structured, he gives an entire budget management, how to do that, entire security management, treasury management, and interestingly he says, how to control corruption. He says, the revenue, the major source of corruption is the revenue department of the government. So nobody should be in the government, revenue department should be made permanent. They should be changed once in 5 or 6 years. He says, then he lists out 42 ways in which government money can be embezzled by the government officers. Very interesting. So, Arthashastra gives a lot of ideas. And great importance he has given to women employees. He says, this number of posts should be reserved for women, which people are fighting even today, even in Western countries. He has said 2,500 years ago, these jobs should be reserved for women. And he says, if it becomes very late for the women employee to go home, the administration should send an escort with them. Such an enlightened viewpoint. Then clarity in communication is a thing. I have given the references for everything Vedas to present. I can send you a copy. My email address is srammohan8@gmail.com. I can send the entire thing. All references will be there. Then cadre of women. The later day assault is not confined to Vedic times. Later day important works on governance administrations have been produced, like VASA in Atnavali, then of course I referred to Daniel Goleman about equilibrium, then Valmiki Ramayanam, then there's a very interesting 17th century work called Viswagunadarsa Champu, which is a satirical work. It talks between two people who are only totally positive and there is power totally negative, Krishna and other person. The whole discussions talk about administration in a very satirical vein. Then one of the kings called Mahendra Varman, the king of Pallava king of the 7th, 8th century, he has written a satirical drama called Matavilasa Prahasanam. What is happening in a drunken brawl in a pub, he has written a drama in putting administration there, administrative aspects. Likewise, from 4th millennium BC up to very late times, the most powerful empire in India, Vijayanagara Empire, was established by a rishi a sannyasi, Shankaracharya of Sringeri Math, Vidyaranya. So everywhere there was a complete harmony, symbiosis between the thinker and the ruler. That showed how the governance should be done. Now we have got disconnected. We think our Vedas and their epics, they are meant for old men and Upanyasas. The government will run on Western principle, which is totally wrong. Bring back those ideas. We will see the rise of nation, Uttishta, Jagrada, because we are the sons, children of immortality, Praptyavaran Nibodhata. Then with a short time, I have done. So, anyway, we will come back, meet again. You can write to me, I'll send the email, I'll have my entire paper to you. We have done a lot of work on that. We'll see. Yes, Rammohan, yes, R-A-M, M-O-H-A-N, numerical 8, number 8, @gmail.com. Yes, Rammohan, 8@gmail.com. So we'll get in touch. And I thank the authorities of WAVES for having given me a platform for airing these views. And thank you, Mr. Ramesh Rao, for efficiently guiding me to complete with it within time. And may pranams to all of you. Namo Ramanam.